Welcome! In this video, we'll introduce you to Jupyter Lab, which is an environment that allows you to easily edit and organize Jupyter Notebooks. Now, you're going to hear the terms Jupyter Lab and Jupyter Notebook a lot. So just to clarify here, when I'm talking about Jupyter Notebook, I'm referring to the actual file. When I'm talking about Jupyter Lab, then that's the environment that organizes my various Jupyter Notebooks that allows me to run them. You also learn how to upload data into Jupyter Lab, create your first Jupyter Notebook, run some code, and add some text and images. When you open up Jupyter Lab for the first time, you'll see that on the left-hand side, you have your files directory, where you can keep track of all of your files, and a launcher screen on the right-hand side. From this launcher, you can create new Jupyter Notebooks, currently available in Python 3, Scala, or R, and there are some other options for more intermediate users to explore, like coding directly in the console, using terminal, or writing your code in a text editor. On CC Labs, there are other features, like Cognos dashboard embedded for data visualization, and some sample Jupyter Notebook tutorials at the bottom. For this video, we'll just focus on the Jupyter Notebooks. Okay, let's first create a notebook in Python 3. And then we can dive into how to use Jupyter Notebooks. Jupyter Notebooks are made up entirely of cells. So you can see in this notebook, there is currently one cell. Let's type something inside the cell, like 1+1, and then on your keyboard, press Shift Enter, which executes the code using Python, and that returns 2. Now we can create even more cells by pressing the plus button at the top, and write more code, like setting x to be equal to the integer 1, and printing the output of x in a cell below. So all of these cells are actually what are called code cells, which allow you to run code using the interpreter, which in this case is Python 3. But how do we add titles or text to our notebook? Well, you will first need to convert the cell type from code into a markdown cell by clicking on a cell, choosing markdown from the drop-down menu. And now if you type in something like 1+1 into this markdown cell and try to run it using Shift Enter, it gets converted directly into text. And to edit it again, simply double click on the cell. Now it's called markdown because it's actually a kind of syntax that allows you to stylize your text. For example, you can create titles or headers by using the pound symbol in a space followed by some text like my title. There are other ways to stylize your text as well, and here are some examples. But I encourage you to look up a markdown formatting guide to find out all the different ways you can format your text. In markdown cells, you can also use HTML as well. For example, if you want to embed an image, you can use the image source tag to embed an image. Now I want to show you, on Jupyter Lab, how to import data like a CSV file and use it in a Jupyter Notebook. To import data, you can simply drag and drop your data file directly into the files directory on the left-hand side. Once the upload is complete, it will show in the directory. And it doesn't have to be CSV, it could be any file type. You can also create different folders to organize all of your files, especially if you're going to be working with lots of notebooks or data files. For CSV files, you can even double-click on the file to open up a preview of its contents, which is really nice. But you can't really do much other than view the contents, however. So if you want to analyze or manipulate the data, that's when you want to use Python, R, or Scala. Let's create a new notebook running Python 3. To import a CSV file in Python, we need to use a readcsv function from the pandas library. So the first step is to import pandas as pd. Next, you can read in the file using the file path to your CSV file. And let's assign it to a variable called df. Now, if you print the head of df,
it should show us the first 5 rows of the CSV file.
So now you've learned how to write and execute code in a Jupyter Notebook, and how to add text, format it, and embed images. Learning how to analyze and manipulate the data is a bit out of the scope of this video, but hopefully you've enjoyed learning how to upload and import data in Jupyter Notebook.